apologize. I'm still getting over a cold, and so my voice may sound a little hoarse this morning.
对不起，我感冒还没有完全康复，我的声音可能还是有一点嘶哑。
I do consider it an incredible privilege to be here to share God's word with you all.
但是真的是非常荣幸能在这里跟大家一起分享神的话语。
And so if you can, open your Bibles to Joshua chapter 24.
请打开圣经在约书亚记第24章。
We'll be reading from verses 14 to 28.
我们从第14节,14节读到28节。
So if we can, may we all stand as we read God's word.
请大家起立, 我们一起来读神的话语。
I'll have Brother Kevin to read it in Mandarin for us.
我来用中文来读。 约书亚记第24章14节。 现在你们要敬畏耶和华，诚心实意地侍奉他，将你们列祖在大河那边和在埃及所侍奉的神除掉，去侍奉耶和华。 若是你们以侍奉耶和华为不好，今日就可以选择所要侍奉的，是你们列祖在大河那边所侍奉的神呢，是你们所住这地的亚摩利人的神呢？至于我和我家，我们必定侍奉耶和华。百姓回答说：我们但不敢离弃耶和华去侍奉别神，因耶和华我们的神曾将我们和我们列祖从埃及地的围炉之家领出来。 在我们眼前行了那些大神迹，在我们所行的道上所经过的诸国都保护了我们。耶和华又把住此地的亚摩利人都从我们面前赶出去，所以我们必侍奉耶和华，因为他是我们的神。约书亚对百姓说：你们不能侍奉耶和华，因为他是圣洁的神，是祭邪的神，必不赦免你们的过犯罪恶。 你们若离弃耶和华去侍奉外邦神，耶和华在降服之后必转而降祸于你们，把你们灭绝。百姓回答约书亚说：“不然，我们定要侍奉耶和华。”约书亚对百姓说：“你们选定耶和华要侍奉他，你们自己做见证吧。”他们说：“我们愿意做见证。”约书亚说：“你们现在要除掉你们中间的外邦神，专心归向耶和华以色列的神。” 百姓回答约书亚说：“我们必侍奉耶和华我们的神，听从他的话。当日，约书亚就与百姓立约，在事件为他们立定律列典章。约书亚将这些话都写在神的律法书上，又将一块大石头立在橡树下耶和华的圣所旁边。约书亚对百姓说：看哪，这石头可以向我们做见证，因为是听见了耶和华所吩咐我们的一切话。” 倘或你们背弃你们的神，这石头就可以向你们做见证。于是约书亚打发百姓各归自己的地业去了。
Will you pray with us?
请我们祷告。
Father, we thank you so much for your word.
主啊，我们感谢你的话语。God,
we pray that this morning you would challenge us and you would convict us today.
真是愿今天早晨你来挑战我们，让我们更深的信靠你。God,
may we see the example that we see from Joshua.
真是让约书亚成为我们的榜样。
God, may we all aspire to make the same declarations.
要我们真是受激励，能够做同样的宣告，在我们的生命当中。
Father, I pray that I would not be in the way of your word.
祷告，真的我不会成为你话语的拦阻。
We pray this in Jesus' name.
奉主耶稣的名祷告。
Amen.
Amen.
You may be seated.
请坐。
You know, last week I had the opportunity, actually last minute, to have to substitute for our two-year-old class at Promised Land Ministry.
上周我要临时去两岁班去代课。
There were no teachers there, so I had to fill in last minute.
因为没有老师，我只好临时要去代课。
And as you can imagine, it was pretty crazy when I got in there.
你可以想象那个教室里面是蛮混乱的。
And so, almost out of desperation, I ran to my office not to escape.
我是没法子，我就想着，我回到，我就跑回我的办公室。But
to grab my guitar so that I could lead some songs of worship.
所以拿了我的吉他，我可以带他们来唱诗。And
the moment I re-entered into the classroom with my guitar,
当我重新回到这个教室，在手上拿着我那把吉他。
All of a sudden, all these eyes just focused on the guitar.
所有这些两岁孩子的眼睛就直勾勾地看着那把吉他。
It was like magic.
就像魔术一般。
But I started to lead these songs, you know, with these kids.
对，我就开始带他们来唱诗。
Familiar songs like Jesus Loves Me or God is so good and Jesus loves the little children.
对，很熟悉的歌，就像耶稣爱我啊，神是如此的美善，耶稣爱小孩。
And you can see that even at 2 years old, these children love to sing songs.
虽然只有两岁，但是你可以看到这些孩子们真的非常喜欢来唱诗。
Now we try to teach them little hand motions like Jesus or Loves Me.
对，我也给他们做一些动作，就像耶稣爱我。
And to see these little bodies try to do the same motions.
看到这些小小的身体就在跟着我一起做了一些动作。
Or after singing a song, I'd be like, "Can you say Jesus?"
啊，我唱完诗以后，我就问他，你们能不能说耶稣？
And I remember one of the little girls.She just kind of crouched over. She goes, "Jesus!"
有一个小女孩，她就说耶稣。
It was so cute.
是非常的可爱。
When after we finished singing "Jesus Loves Me,"
我们唱完耶稣爱我之后
，one of the little boys in the class
有一个小男孩
，because they're so limited in their words, but they know the baby motions of more, more.
虽然他们能说的话不多，但是从他的那个动作，我大家看出来，再唱再唱。
So every time we sang, more, 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 more.
我每次我们唱完以后，他说还再来一次，再来一次。
We sang "Jesus Loves Me" 6 times.
我们唱耶稣爱我唱了6次。
But I share this with you this morning.
我为什么跟大家分享这个故事
？Because hearing kids' songs or kids sing or proclaiming the name of Jesus is one of the most beautiful sounds one could ever ask for.
因为听小孩子唱诗赞美耶稣的名是这世界上最美妙的声音之一。
Having led worship for so many years, especially at youth retreats.
我就有很多带敬拜的经历特别是在一些青少年的退休会上。
I had the opportunity to lead worship from stage.
所以说我是站在台上来带领敬拜。
And I had the amazing privilege and honor to hear these kids.Sing these songs, crying out these songs of worship.
我就是非常的有荣幸的有这样的机会来看到这些年轻人，真是从心底里来发声来赞美神。
I had the opportunity to see them lifting their hands in worship of our God.
我看他们举起手来高声的赞美神。
Again, it's the most beautiful sight and most beautiful sound that I've experienced.
这是一幅最美丽的图画，也是最美妙的声音。
And it reminds me of the passage in Matthew chapter 21 where Jesus said, out of the mouth of infants and nursing babies, you have prepared praise.
就像耶稣在马太福音21:16中所说的，他说，你从婴孩或吃奶的口中完全了赞美的话。
This morning, we're continuing to look at this series from 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9, and we're looking at the section of proclaiming the excellencies of God.
今天早晨我们继续来看，就是我们今年奥斯汀华人教会的主题经文，就是在彼得前书2:9。我们看其中的那一部分，就是说来宣扬神的美德。
And so to further expound on this passage, we are looking at the story in Joshua 24.
为了进一步要阐明这一段话，我们来看约书亚记24。
By the time we get to this passage in Joshua 24, the Israelites have now entered into the promised land.
就是在约书亚记第24的时候，我们知道以色列人已经进入应许之地。
The entire generation that had left in the Exodus, they've all now died off, except for Joshua and his friend Caleb.
除了约书亚和加勒以外，所有出埃及的那一代人都死去了。
And this new generation, as they were entering into Canaan, they've already experienced so many things, so many sets of miracles and trials and wars as they were in the land of Canaan.
这新的一代人进入应许之地，这新的一代人，他们也经历了神莫大的神迹、试炼和战争。
And as Joshua's time is ending, his life is near his end. He's demonstrating this one last act of leadership.
这时候，约书亚在日的时日已经不多了，他是在最后让他作为一个领袖所做的一件事情。
Proclaiming before all the people of Israel his dedication for him and his family to serve the Lord.
就在所有的以色列人面前来做这样一个宣告，就是他和他的全家要坚定地侍奉耶和华。
And this proclamation is a very well-known one.
这个宣告是大家都非常熟悉的。
Maybe some of us here in this room, we have this verse hung up somewhere in our house.
可能在座的有些人家里面有这样一个牌子，就是挂在墙上。
As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord.
上面就是写的十四章的一段话，十四节的一段话。至于我和我家，我必定侍奉耶和华。
But as many of us know, or maybe we've experienced that.Having a plaque hanging somewhere in our house doesn't necessarily mean that we're necessarily proclaiming it in our lives.
但是我们知道有一块牌子挂在墙上并不代表在我们的生命当中我们是真的是会这样来宣告神的美德。
And so we see from this passage this morning, true proclamation must stem from three things.
所以我们今天来看这段经文的时候我们可以来思想一个真实的宣告要从三个方面来得来。
Our proclamation must come from what is good.
必须从美善而来。
Our proclamation must come from our conviction.
必须从我们的信念而来。
And our proclamation must come from our commitment.
这样的宣告也必须从我们的委身而来。
So first we're going to be looking at this idea of proclamation or proclaiming from what is good.
首先我们来看来宣扬是美善的。
One of the early things that we learn, as we learn about Bible reading and understanding,
我们在读经的时候，我们会要注意一点
is that particularly in English, whenever we see this word therefore,
在英文里面，如果你看到因此这个词
we should always ask the question, what is that therefore there for?
我们必须要问自己，这个因此为什么要放在这里？它是因什么词呢？
It's an English play on words.
好像只是英文的一个文字游戏。
But it's always a very useful reminder.
但是是非常有用的提醒。
And so we see in our first verse in verse 14, it says, Now therefore fear the Lord and serve him in sincerity and in faithfulness.
所以我们在看第二十四章十四节的时候，我知道可能我们的那个翻译这个是没有，但是在英文的这个 ESV 里面是有这个 therefore 这个词啊。他说因此我加进去哈因此现在你们要敬畏耶和华诚心实意地侍奉他
So we understand, yes, we should fear the Lord and serve him.
所以我们要敬畏侍奉耶和华
But why? Why is that therefore there?
那为什么因此这个词在这里呢
If we were to quickly look at the first 13 verses in chapter 24, we see why.
如果我们很快地看一下前面的十三节，我们就能够找到这个原因。
Because in these verses, we see a very quick history of everything that God had done.
因为在这个前十三节，就很简略地把神降服以色列的这样一个历史，把它表述了出来。
Everything all the way from Abraham, all the way when he promised a great nation coming from him.
就从应许耶和华亚伯拉罕必成为大国开始。
And history all the way to where they were now with the Israelites as they were in the promised land.
一直到那个时候以色列人进入这个应许之地。
And all throughout these verses, if you were to scan it, you would see this one repeating word, I.
所以你看这个十三节的经文的时候，你会看到一个重复的字，就是我。
Starting in verse 3, it says, I took, I led, I made you a great nation.
所以第三节是我带，我领，我赐。
Verse 4, and this is a long thing, so we're not going to get into everyone, but as you look through all of these verses, I did this, I gave this, I sent you out, I plagued this.
所以说因为很长我们不每一节来看但是看这些经文的时候你看到有我给我差遣我降灾我领出我交给我灭绝我交给我打发我赐给
So if you were to scan through all those things, we see all the things that God did.
所以说你快速的在这个看一遍的时候你看到所有这是神的作为
All the good that God did for the people of Israel
所以所有这些神为以色列人所降的福
And these are all things that are worthy of being proclaimed by the people of Israel
所有这些事情都是值得以色列人去宣扬的
Joshua is reminding them all the good that God had done on their behalf
所以约书亚在这里就是提醒他们所有神所降福给他们的所的祝福给他们
So he says therefore fear and serve the Lord
所以他这里说因此你们要敬畏侍奉耶和华
I was reading an article recently about customer satisfactions and reviews
我最近读了一篇关于消费者满意度 或他们这个评论的文章。
And in this article, it said that people were more likely to post negative reviews to complain about a product rather than posting a positive review to praise the product.
他说人有一个倾向更倾向于写一些负面的评论，而不是正面的评价。
In fact, only 1 in 10 people would actually write a positive review to talk about their experience about it.
So, 在十个有正面体验的人当中，大概只有一位会去写一个正面的评论。
And so, as I read further, according to research, it said it took about 40 positive reviews to offset the negative impact from one negative review.
我进一步读下去的时候，就根据研究。其实要需要有40个正面的评价才能抵消一个负面评价的影响。
And as I thought about it, humanity, as people, we have a propensity to want to focus on the negative.
所以我在思想的时候，实际上我们人都有一个更关注于负面体验的倾向。
And so we have a tendency to proclaim all the bad things.That happened to us.
所以我们愿意去分享我们的一些不好的事情发生在我们身上的。
But Joshua is saying here in this passage, don't you see all the good that God has done in your life?
但是约书亚在这里说，你看到所有这些神为你们所成就的美事吗？
If so, then choose this day who you will serve.
所以说，如果你看到了，今天你就来选择你到底要侍奉谁。
Proclaim all the good so that your family hears it.
所以宣扬美事，让你的，让你的家人能听到。
So that your friends hear it.
让你的朋友中来宣告。
So that your coworkers hear it.
让你的同事中同事能听到。
Now in this generation, we are living in what's called the New Covenant or New Testament times.
我们生活在一个新约的时代。
We have the greatest news of all in the Gospel of Christ.
我们有最好的消息，就是主耶稣基督的福音。
That while we were yet still sinners, Christ died for us, so that we can be restored into a right relationship with God.
就是在我们还做罪人的时候，耶稣为我们死了，让我们能够重新与神和好。
This is the best news that anyone could ever ask for.
这是天下最好的消息。
And as believers, we should be proclaiming it as loud and as proud as possible.
像主的门徒，我们都应该要大声的，以最就是感到最有光荣的去来宣告这个消息。
Especially to our kids.
为特别是对我们的孩子。
Our kids need to see us as parents proclaiming the excellencies of God as often as possible.
我们的孩子需要看到我们常常来宣扬神的美德。
At home, they should hear us talking about God.
在家我们要看到我们来谈论神。
They should hear about what He's been doing in our lives.
他们要听到神在我们生命中的作为。
They should be aware of what God is doing in their lives.
他们应该要能够清楚地知道了解神在他们身上的作为。
And what He's doing in our family's life.
在我们整个家庭生活中的作为。
And what He's doing in our church's life.
在我们教会生活中的作为。
And together we proclaim that.As a family unit.
所以我们全家一起来宣扬神的美德。
Joshua's statement is not as for me.
约书亚在这里说的不是说只与我。
Clearly it says, as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord.
只与我和我家我们必定侍奉耶和华。
Second, our proclamation must come from our conviction.
第二点就是我们的宣扬必须要从我们自己坚定的信念而来。
When you look at verse 15, Joshua says, "Choose this day who you will serve, whether the gods your father served in the region beyond the river, or the gods of the Amorites in whose land you currently dwell."
在第十五节，约书亚说，今日就要选择所要侍奉的，是你们列祖在大河那边侍奉的神呢，是你们所住这地亚摩利人的神呢？
Then we see the Israelites' response in verse 18. Yes, we will serve God.
我说在第十八节，我们看到以色列众人的回应说，我们要侍奉耶和华。
But God, but Joshua, interestingly, he responds with this in verse 19. You are not able to serve the Lord, for He is a holy God, and He is a jealous God.
但是在十九节约书亚对他们的回应，他说你们不能侍奉耶和华，因为他是圣洁的神，是祭邪的神。
Joshua experienced this firsthand with these Israelites, that the Israelites were a fickle people.
因为约书亚亲眼地见到了以色列人是一群善变的人。
Their minds and their hearts flip-flop, they change back and forth all the time.
他们的心思意念变来变去。
They struggled with conviction.
他们没有一个坚定的信念。
Conviction is defined as a firmly held belief or being firmly convinced about something.
信念的定义是深信一个意念或者事物。
Proclaiming the excellencies of God is not meant to be half-hearted.
宣扬神的美德不能半心半意的去做。
It's not saying that, well, today, yes, I will proclaim the excellencies of God, but tomorrow I just don't feel like it.
不能说我今天有兴趣宣扬，明天我就不太愿意。
Or today I will serve God, but tomorrow I really just need to focus on my work.
所以说，今天我要真是来侍奉神，那明天我的重心要放在我的工作上。
Or I really need to think about my money.
或者是我的财富。
Or I really need to think about my family or my kids' activities.
或者是我的家庭和孩子们的各项活动。
Or it's about my retirement.
或者是我的退休计划。
And while all those things I just mentioned are good things,
所以我刚刚提的这些事情并不是坏事。
If we are to proclaim about our convictions must be about God and God alone.
但是我们要宣扬神的美德，但是我们的信念应该是要坚信只是单单的在神身上。
And so all those other things fall under our conviction for God.
所有的那些事情上是在对我们行对神的信靠的之下。
This is why Jesus said in Matthew 6, you cannot both serve God and money.
这是为什么耶稣在马太福音第六章说，他说你们不能侍奉神又侍奉马门。
This is why the Apostle Paul wrote in Ephesians 4,
这是为什么保罗在以弗所书第四章写道，
that maturity in Christ means not being tossed to and fro by every wave and wind of doctrine.
一个成熟的基督徒不应该被一切异教之风摇动，飘来飘去。
We must know the truth of the gospel.
我们应该要真正明白福音的真道。
And we must proclaim our convictions of the gospel, not be turned by every single message that we hear from the world.
所以我们宣扬我们对福音的坚信不疑，而不是被世界上各种的声音来动摇。
This is what Joshua understood.
这是约书亚说。
Joshua knew that the Israelites at one moment could praise God and worship God for all the good that he's done.
他知道那些以色列人这一阵可能会来赞美神，因为神看到神为他们所做的这些美事。
And then just like that, at a flip of a hat, see the false gods that surround them around the nations and start worshiping these idols.
下一会儿又会去随从那些外邦人的假神。
He was trying to make abundantly clear that God cannot tolerate a compromised heart of worship.
他就是清楚的要跟他们讲明，就是说他清楚的讲明，他们是不能脚踩两只船的。
With conviction, you cannot play on two teams.
就是说有一个有坚定信念的人不会脚踩两只船。
When I wrote that, the first picture that entered my mind.
当我写到以后，第一幅图画在我脑中出现的是
was that if I were to ask Elder Shintower to wear a Texas A&M shirt.
我一个想要那个信涛长老穿一件这个德州农工大学的这个T 恤衫。
Because those that know him, he is a rabid UT fan.
你们熟悉他的都知道，他是一个这个Longhorn 的这个坚定的这个拥棒。
You cannot play on two teams.
你不能脚踩两只船，在两要踩这个拥护两个队。
Amen, Elder Shintower. That is one of the things that God hates most.
这是神最恨恶的一件事。
In the book of Revelation, we see this clearly as Jesus is speaking to the church of Laodicea.
在启示录当中，我们看到耶稣有谈到老底家教会。
And Jesus writes this, because you are lukewarm, I will spit you out.
耶稣当时这么说，他说，你就像那个温水。不冷也不热，所以我要将我的口中把你吐出去。
Some synonyms for lukewarm are half-hearted.
有一些这个温吞水的这个同义词就是半心半意。
unexcited,
不兴奋,
indifferent,
淡漠,
subdued,
折服的,
apathetic,
麻木不仁的,
uninterested,
冷漠的。
And I'm sure every one of us parents here,
所以我们在这里做父母的,
we would never want to describe our kids that way.
可能都不愿意用这些词来描述我们的孩子。
And so you can imagine it's the same with God.
可以想象，对神来讲，这也是一样的。
Many recent church studies are showing that this generation of young people are becoming more and more disinterested with God and church.
现在很多对关于教会成长的研究表明，现在的年轻人对教会、对神也越来越没有兴趣。
They don't have a solid foundation of the Bible because they don't hear it enough at home.
他们没有坚实的圣经基础，因为在家中他们听得很少。
Like I said before, we need to be proclaiming, talking about our faith at home with our kids.
所以我在前面说过，我们需要常在我们的家中谈论我们的信仰。
But our proclamation is not just our words.
但是我们的宣扬不仅仅是在停留在字句上。
Proclaiming His excellencies is also about our actions.
宣扬神的美德更体现在我们的行动上。
It's about what we do.
是做我们的行动能表现出来的。
So our kids don't just have to hear us talking about it.
所以我们的孩子不只是听到我们的说教。
They actually need to see us living it out.
他更需要看到我们真实的活出我们的信仰。
Because as I think about my own life,
我想象我自己的生活。
Our kids, they see us when we're stressed about work.
我们孩子在我们就是工作中非常有压力的时候，孩子会看到我们。
They see us when we fight or argue with one another.
但是我们彼此有这些争论的时候、冲突的时候，他们也会看到。
They see us when we're impatient.
当我们没有耐心的时候，他们会看到。
They see.We're here when the majority of our conversations with our kids are about their studies or about their laziness or about all these other things that bother us.
他们也会看到我们所谈论最多的事情是他们学校的功课，或者是他们有多懒，或者是其他这个让我们心烦的事。
And so they see how we ourselves use our time at home.
他会看到我们是如何分配使用我们的时间。
There's an old proverb or saying that says that the apple doesn't fall far from the tree.
有一句英文的这个俗语，他说就是按直译的话，应该是苹果掉梨树不会太远。但如果按意译翻的话，是有其父必有其子。
Meaning that the things that we are convicted by,
就是说我们坚信的是什么。
Or the things that we are most passionate about,
我们最热衷的事情是什么。
Or what we talk about.
我们谈论的最多的是什么？
Often our kids adopt the very same behaviors and mannerisms and habits.
所以我们的孩子大部分这个时候就会大概受这些影响，会有相同的行为或表现出相同的习惯。
So I ask, what are we convicted about, and what are we proclaiming in word and action before our children?
所以在我们的孩子面前，到底我们用我们的行动，用我们的言语，到底我们宣扬的是什么呢？
May our homes be filled with godly conversations.
愿我们家充满敬虔的对话。
And godly praise.
敬虔的赞美。
Godly actions.
敬虔的行动。
That teach and train our children also to be passionate for the Lord.
教导和训练我们的孩子对神充满激情。
That our children themselves may be convicted of the truth.Of the gospel.
这样他们也对福音的真道能够深信不疑。
And for those of us maybe who are even grandparents, as we think about the second and third generation, that their families in the future would also proclaim it for themselves and for their future families.
所以我们这些做爷爷奶奶的，希望能看到我们的孩子，甚至他们自己的家庭中，也能这样来宣扬神的美德。
Finally, our proclamation must come from commitment.
最后，我们的宣扬要从我们的委身而来。
Now, if any of you have ever seen those unfortunate workout equipment infomercials on TV, maybe late at night.
如果你曾经看过在电视上看过那种就是健身器材的电视购物节目。
Have any of you ever seen those?
有人看过这样的节目吗？
A couple of people.
有几个人举手。
Or some of you are too ashamed to admit it.
有些人可能不好意思举手。
But if, you know, these are all about testimonies, right?
这是都是主要是他们里面都是用的很多的证词。
Not once in any of those commercials have you ever seen a testimony that said, "Oh yeah, I just tried it one time and then I quit."
你们有没有看到过这样的证词？哎呀，我试了一次我就放弃了。
Right? Or I tried it and I actually gained 15 pounds and I gained two dress sizes.
或者我试了，但实际上我加了40磅，我的衣服的尺码加了两个号码。
No, they say, oh, I tried it 15 minutes a day for 3 months and I lost 40 pounds.
一般的证词都会这么说，我每天我试了15分钟，我这个就是能够掉了15磅。
Nobody ever plans or wants to share about their failures.
没有人愿意去分享他们的失败。
These are all success, quote unquote, success stories.
这些电视里面用的证词都是所谓这些成功的故事。
It's about progress or growth and improvement.
都是谈到的是他们的进步。
As we think about commitment, commitment is not an instantaneous change.
我们谈到尾声的时候，尾声不是一个瞬间的改变。
Commitment is about progress.
尾声是表示每天进步一点点。
And as we see in this passage, we see these warnings that Joshua issues to the Israelites.
我们在看这些经文的时候，我们看到约书亚对以色列人的警告。
Starting in verse 19, you are not able to serve the Lord. He will not forgive your transgressions or your sins.
在第十九节他说你们不能侍奉耶和华，然后你看到后面的一部分，他说他必不赦免你们的过犯罪恶。
In verse 20, if you forsake the Lord and serve foreign gods, then he will turn and do you harm and consume you after having done you good.
然后在第二十节说你们若离弃耶和华去了侍奉外邦的神，耶和华在降福之后必然降祸于你们，把你们灭绝。
And after the Israelites even said we will commit,Joshua says one more time in verse 22, you are witnesses against yourselves that you have chosen the Lord to serve him.
这个在以色列甚至在说他们愿意委身侍奉耶和华之前，在第二十二节约书亚再次说你们选择耶和华要侍奉他，你们自己见证吧。
Now we have to give the Israelites a bit of credit here. They actually commit to follow God.
就在这里我们也要给以色列人一些信用，因为他这里他们承诺他们会要侍奉而跟随神。
Unfortunately, if you read the rest of the Bible, we know the rest of the story.
但是很不幸的时候，你继续在读圣经的时候，我们知道这些后面的故事怎么样。
They fail miserably for thousands of years.
他们真的是几千年都一直在跌倒。
Throughout the Old Testament history, we see they commit and then they fall and then they recommit.And then they fall.
在整个旧约的历史中，我们看到他们承诺，他们跌倒，再承诺，再跌倒。
I think if we're being honest, we would see that this is actually the story of our lives.
如果我们诚实地面对自己，大概这也是我们每一个人我们的生命的故事。
And though we fail time and time and time again,
虽然我们一次又一次地跌倒
，God is faithful and gracious and merciful to us over and over.And over again.
但信实仁慈和满有恩典的神一次一次地把我们扶起。
True proclamation about our commitment is not about how successful we are.
我们委身的真实宣告并不是宣扬我们有多么成功。
True proclamation is about how faithful God is to us.
真实的宣告是神对我们有多么的信实。
So proclaiming the excellencies of God is not about declaring how good we are.
所以宣扬神的美德不是说我们有多好。
It's not about proclaiming how good our family or our kids are.
也不是宣扬我们的孩子、我们的家庭有多么的了不起。
It's not about announcing how great our church is.
甚至都不是关于我们的教会有多么的了不起。
But it's testifying how amazing God's grace is every single day in our lives.
而是每一天来见证神那奇妙的见证神的恩典是多么的奇异。
No matter what stage in life you are in as parents,
不管你在做父母的哪一个阶段
，we can all testify as growing up that our kids have disappointed us many times.
大概我们都可以分享知道，在他们成长的过程当中，我们的孩子多少次的让我们失望。
But as much as they disappointed us, we also failed them.
但实际上。就像他们让我们失望，其实我们也有多少的次，我们也让他们失望。
The greatest news is that no matter how much or how many times we fail,
好消息是说，不管我们曾经跌倒多少次
，Our God never fails.
但是我们的神是永不跌倒的神。
He has never failed, nor will he ever fail.
他从没有失约，但永远也不会失约。
And it reminded me of that song we sang last week, God is so good.
就像我想起上星期我跟孩子们唱的一首歌，神是如此的美善。
It's the same line over and over. God is so good. God is so good. He's so good to me.
他说，在那首诗里，那在那首诗歌里面，就是说，神是如此的美善，上帝是如此的美善，上帝是如此的美善，他对我如此的美善。
Again, commitment is not a one-time thing.
所以委身不是一次性的事。
It's ongoing.
是一个持续进行的事情。
And so we need to commit to Him each and every day to live for Him and to serve Him.
我们真的是每一天都要委身为他而活，来侍奉他。
Every day we need to encourage our kids to do the same.
每一天我们要鼓励我们的孩子，也来这样来对神委身。
We need to learn to extend grace every day, just as God extends grace to us.
我们要学习对别人满有恩慈，就像神对我们满有恩典一样。
And so today, extend grace to your wife or to your husband.
所以今天对你的妻子或者丈夫多有恩典。
Extend grace to your kids or kids that are here. Extend grace to your parents.
对你的孩子或者是对你的父母多有恩典。
Extend grace to your coworkers.
对你的同事多有恩典。
Extend grace to your sisters and brothers here.
对教会的弟兄姊妹多有恩典。
And please extend grace to your pastors.
也请对牧师多有恩典。
Proclaiming His excellencies is something that we do one day at a time.
宣扬他的 美德是我们每一天每一天的去做。
I started out this sermon with that little story of our two-year-old class in Promised Land.
我在这篇讲到的一开始跟大家分享了一个在那个两岁班的代课的事。
What a beautiful sound it was to hear them singing and shouting out the name of Jesus.
听到他们真是喊出耶稣的名字，实在是多么美妙。
At home, it's the same thing.
在家里也是一样的。
When we sing songs together,
让我们一起来唱诗。
When we recite verses together,
让我们一起真是朗读神的话语。
When we pray or read the Bible together,
当我们一起祷告一同读经。
Or we just share stories with one another,
我们一起彼此分享神在我们生命中的故事。
Together we're proclaiming the excellencies of God as a family.
我们一起在宣扬，作为一个家庭，我们一起在宣扬神的美德。
And it's always a beautiful sight and a beautiful sound.
这总是一幅这么美丽的图画和那么动听的声音。
May we all testify of God's goodness in our lives.
让我们都来见证神在我们生命中的美好。
May we all be able to declare together, as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord together.
让我们一起来宣告。至于我和我家，我们必定侍奉耶和华。
Let's pray.
让我们一起祷告。
Father, again, we thank you so much for your word.
主啊，我们再次感谢你的话语。
God, we thank you that you are always the unfailing one who's committed to us.
你是守约是慈爱的神。
God, we thank you for all the ways that you've called each and every one of us and grown us, God, in a special way.
但是你也呼召我们，真是用你每一个人独特的方式来建造我们。
Lord, may you grant us the strength and the grace to proclaim your excellencies to the world around us.
愿你赐我们力量和恩典，就是在我们周围的世界当中去宣扬你的美德。
God, start with us.
从我们的家开始。
God, and extend it to our families.
在我们的家中。
And send us out.
把我们差遣出去。
God, we give you all the praise and honor and glory.
所有的赞美、尊贵、荣耀都是你的。
We pray this in Jesus' name.
奉主耶稣基督的名祷告。
Amen.
Amen.